How was the Grand Canyon formed? Standing beneath the high walls of the Grand Canyon, it's human to think, how was the Grand Canyon formed? Painted in fiery orange, blushed red, and deep purple hues, every layer of the Grand Canyon's high walls tells an untold story of ancient oceans, swamps, and forests that vanished thousands of years ago. Neither an alien's work nor a hit of some laser beam. It's purely a depiction of what nature does to your Earth over geological periods. In this video, we will uncover the mysterious formation of the Grand Canyon through the lens of science and geology. So, let's dive in and see what no one has ever told you before. One of the seven natural wonders of the world, the Grand Canyon is a massive river valley in the state of Arizona in the USA, reaching up to a mile deep, 18 miles wide, and 277 miles long. It has steep walls that were carved over millions of years. This majestic canyon is still a home to many creatures. However, the history of its formation and people's self-taught theories is more complex. Looking at the Grand Canyon's incredible formation, some people have even thought that this canyon was carved by some advanced alien civilization as a mark of their presence. And some others believed that a giant laser beam, perhaps from a natural or alien source, sliced through the Earth's crust to create the canyon. These were just assumptions of ancient folks who lived near the canyon and were impressed by its greatness. The truth is far more fascinating. It's a story written in the relentless whispers of time. Slowly but steadily. Systematic scientific study of the Grand Canyon began in the mid-18th century with explorers like John Wesley Powell. Over the last 150 plus years, geologists have put together a timeline. They did radiometric dating on rock layers, analyzed fossils, and studied erosion patterns. Even today, they're using advanced technologies to provide the most accurate insights into specific aspects of the formation process. According to their findings, the formation of the Grand Canyon results from grand geological drama created by multiple factors in 2 billion years. It's like a potter making an earthen vase, making mud, shaping the vase, cooking it in the fire to make it strong, and then polishing it with beautiful colors. Nature formed the walls of the Grand Canyon, and the waters of the Colorado River, wind, and weather joined together to polish and paint these high walls and expose their attractive, colorful layers. These all expose their colorful history. But what happened first? Let's begin with the timeline. It started with the emergence of the Colorado Plateau about 2 billion years ago. The movement of Earth's tectonic plates over the mantle uplifted the vast region of the Grand Canyon slowly. This slow geological lifting created the vast but flat Colorado Plateau on Earth's face and set the stage for other geological events that played a role in carving and sculpting the most amazing walls of the Grand Canyon, one after another. Since the valley of the Colorado Plateau was deep enough, the surrounding seas rushed to cover the region and form shallow seas. Marine life was there in these waters for over 5 to 6 million years. Sand, silt, dissolved minerals, and marine life's fossils also were deposited in the sea's bottom to form layers of sediment. Marine life's fossils also settled within the layers of sediment on the seafloor. These ancient sediments compressed and hardened over time and formed the lower layers of the canyon walls, most as limestones. It was like layering the seashells one over another. Thus, giant layers of the canyon kept building up. 1 billion years ago, volcanic eruptions and intrusions left behind layers of fiery magma rock that became part of the canyon's foundation. Additionally, scattered volcanic elements throughout the canyon's history deposited ash and lava. Over several millions of years, with the shift of geological forces, the seas moved away, and the deposited layers of sediments on the bottom hardened into giant rocks. With the climate change, heavy rains blessed this region by forming swamps and lush forests. Many freshwater streams watered the area. Resultantly, green and dense forests became the homes of hundreds of species. As life thrived, the remains of these plants and animals added to the ever-growing layers of sediment. Wind and rivers also played a role. They carried sand and debris that compacted and became part of the canyon's story. Each color of the Grand Canyon speaks of these changes. The red and orange color of the layers hints at the higher oxidation conditions when the region's surface was exposed to air, while deeper reds can also hint at ancient volcanic activity. Contrarily, lighter shades like yellows and whites might be sandstone formed from porous sand dunes. These layers and the fossils present in the layers of the canyon have allowed scientists to explain the evidence-based history of the Grand Canyon's evolution. The exposed rock layers in the canyon walls also have different compositions and hardness. Softer rock, like shale, erodes faster than harder rock, Like limestone, this differential erosion rate creates the dramatic stepped effect and the uneven shelves and slopes seen in the canyon. But guess what? The real sculpting still didn't happen. In 1858, American geologist John Newberry proposed that the Colorado River itself carved the canyon over millions of years. According to him, around 5 to 6 million years ago, another important event happened that formed today's Colorado River. A further movement of our Earth's plate tilted the plateau slightly. It caused the smaller streams to connect together and flow in a southwestern direction. They formed a single but most dynamic water flow. This became the beginning of the Colorado River you know today. As this river flowed through the deep valley with high walls, it carved through the soft rock layers with unbelievable erosive power. Over millions of years, this downcutting created the canyon's immense depth and revealed the colorful story of its formation. Even today, the flow of the Colorado River, along with wind and weather, continues to erode and shape the canyon. The river carves deeper, widens the canyon walls, and creates new features like side canyons and rapids. However, the symmetrical colors of the layers on the canyon's walls offer clues to the past. Reds and oranges hint at times when the seas left the area and wet walls were exposed to higher oxygen levels in the air. On the other hand, deeper reds suggest volcanic activity in the region. Lighter shades like yellow and white are because of the sandstone formed from ancient sand dunes. The story of the Grand Canyon's formation isn't over. Though millions of years old, it's a dynamic landscape. The Colorado River and other natural forces are still shaping its vastness. Even today, the wind howls, the sun beats down, and water relentlessly carves the canyon walls, revealing new layers and sculpting its ever-changing beauty. Millions of years from now, future geologists might be studying your era. Every month, thousands of tourists visit this natural wonder, leaving their footprints, a potential future layer in the canyon story. Today, the Grand Canyon is facing a new threat. Dams on the Colorado River are reducing its erosive power. It's slowing down the canyon's future changes. In a million years, could these dams be buried deep within the canyon walls? A silent testament to our impact? Future geologists might find remnants of our time, like tiny plastic particles, altered river flow patterns, or even microscopic pollutants trapped within the rock layers. Our actions will leave a subtle but lasting mark on this natural wonder. These would be subtle signs compared to the dramatic rock layers, but a powerful reminder of our presence. The Grand Canyon tells you the story of our Earth, its forces, and the beauty it creates. You can witness millions of years of geological history unfold before your eyes in this magnificent landscape. Just like the layers in the canyon walls, each of us leaves our own mark on this planet, shaping its future. As visitors and caretakers of this natural wonder, it's our responsibility to preserve it for future generations to come. Let us know in the comments below what amazed you the most about the Grand Canyon and how it has changed your perspective on our planet's history. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to like and share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more exciting content.